40.7 is the success ratio of engineering students in the civil services examination, whereas for the humanities, it's just 40.5%. So yes, engineering students are getting the upper hand. They are succeeding more in the civil services examination over the past few years, and this trend is expected to continue over the next 5 to 6 years. So yes, dear friends, today's video is all about utilizing your engineering background to your advantage in the civil services examination. Let's begin with the first point, that is for the CSAT examination. When it was started, it was an examination that gave a major upper hand to all the engineering or technical background students, because the marks scored in this examination were considered in your qualification. But now the CSAT examination has become just a qualifying paper, and the marks secured are not considered in the final list. But for you, if you are an engineering student, how this can be used as an advantage, even though it's a qualifying paper? Well, you have to understand that people from the humanities background or people from not so technical backgrounds have to still give some amount of effort, give some amount of preparation time, revision time for the CSAT examination, even though it's a qualifying paper, because they have that kind of pressure, they have that kind of burden that they are not comfortable with the subjects asked in this aptitude examination. But you are an engineering student, and the paper is very well under your control. You have the technical background to crack this examination with ease. So the amount of effort that you need to put in this examination is reduced by half as compared to what your peers from the humanities background will put in this examination. Utilize this advantage to save your time and give that time, energy and effort towards preparation in the general studies syllabus. The second advantage, and a very, very big advantage, is that of facing the competitive examination. Yes, engineering students have gone through various entrance exams. The earlier scheme had different kinds of entrance exams for different colleges throughout the country. So many of the students who have done their engineering and are now preparing for the civil services examination, you have gone through lots of entrance examinations and you have the experience of facing the same. You know what it takes to stand out from the competition. You are not enrolled in an engineering college based on your class 12th examination marks. Instead, you need to do something extra. You need to develop that kind of character, that kind of responsibility, that kind of discipline in your schedule to get enrolled in a top engineering college. So you have this advantage that you have gone through the process of a competitive examination, which your friends and peers from the humanities background have not got. So yes, it is very important that you utilize this experience to manage your stress, to manage your time, to understand how to cover vast syllabus in a limited amount of time. You have already done it in the past, you can do it again. The third very important advantage is that of analytical mindset. Yes, in the engineering studies, you are made to analyze and think scientifically, which develops a mindset where you don't look at things in one direction, but you look at it in a wholesome manner. And such answers are expected in the UPSC mains examination. So utilize your technical background, your analytical mindset that engineering background has developed to stand out in the UPSC mains examination. What the humanities peers will be doing is they will think from one direction, they will think from the humanities background. But you, as an engineering graduate or an engineering master's degree, you have the advantage of having a sound technical knowledge as well as having a good balance of humanities subjects, because you are going to study it in your general studies, and there are many students from technical background who also choose humanities as their optional subjects. So you can have a good balance of both technical as well as humanities background and give a very wholesome answer in UPSC mains examination. So do take care of this point and utilize it to your advantage. The fourth advantage is interview stage and optional selection. Yes, lot of students from technical background have this advantage that options from both the subject, options from both the streams are open to them. One, the technical background from which they have done their graduation is open to them, and the subject from the humanities background is also very scoring for them. So people from engineering background have more number of options to choose from as compared to their peers in the humanities field. So yes, it's very important that we take this advantage and we see where our comfort zone lies, in which subject are we most interested in, most comfortable in, which is the subject which has lots and lots of material and lots of help available in the market. So yes, when you have this vast opportunity available, it's only a fool who would not take the advantage of this situation. So yes, engineering students, you have double the number of options available for you to select from. So be very careful and select either a technical subject or a humanities subject based on your comfort zone with the subject. Let's also discuss the advantage that you will get in the interview stage. If you are from an engineering background or any other technical background, the questions more or less might appear in the frame of latest developments in your field or any technical questions that are related to your field. So you have to understand that this is a risky situation where your answer could be either right or the answer could be wrong. So today, since we are discussing the advantages, let's focus on utilizing this as an advantage. Imagine your level of expertise in this field to be so good that you have only correct answers to give. So you have to understand that there is no ambiguity in the interview stage. If the questions are from a technical nature, from a technical background, you will give right answers, and that will help you to score full marks for all those questions being asked in the interview stage. So yes, it's a risky situation, I would not deny it, but if you gain the expertise in your field of graduation for 4 or 5 years which you have spent in your engineering, then definitely the interview stage will be a very smooth process for you. It will be like a cakewalk for you. The last advantage is that engineering is a much better backup plan as compared to BA, BSc or BCom. So yes, engineering colleges are coming up in all the locations throughout the country, which is why the job opportunities are lesser and lesser in our country. But as compared to the BA, BCom and the BSc degrees, engineering degree has still much more importance. It has much more value in the job market, and hence if you create engineering as your backup option, you have that kind of satisfaction in your head that even if civil services you could not crack it, you still have the option of taking a master's degree in this field, in your technical field, and going and taking up a job. Yes, engineering serves as a much better backup option if you are supposed to prepare for a civil services examination. So now you know the advantages of being an engineering student if you want to prepare for a civil services examination. So if you are a parent who is watching this video for their children, or you are a student of say class 12 standard who is aspiring to become a civil servant in the future, my recommendation to you is that do not go for any other plain bachelor's degree course. Instead, go for engineering or any other technical course and get that analytical mindset, face that competitive exam and develop those technical skills which will give you an upper hand as compared to all your other peers who are preparing for the civil services examination. If you like this video, please do subscribe to this channel and share this video with all those people who are preparing for the civil services examination, or even with class 10th and 12th standard students who aspire to become civil servants, because it is going to be very helpful to each one of them. I will see you next week with another video that will help you in your civil services examination. Until then, bye, all the best.